Today, it's gonna kind of a continuation of part one, and I'm gonna focus this session on talking about the CDI enablement and also some best practices. Right. So first, I'm gonna talk about the CDI enablement, and then I'll talk about some best practices. I'll first talk about best practices after right after the CDI enablement, and then some general things that are you need to keep in mind. All right, so this is the topic of today. Let's first start with our CDI enablement. So what is the CDI enablement and what's the impact on Alma? Keep in mind that before CDI, all your search activations were handled in what we call the Primo Central Institutional Profile. You see here on the left side. So when you registered with Primo Central, you got a link. To a page, you also could link from your Primo V or your Primo back office to this page, and it allowed you to do activations for collections that you could search in Primo Central. So now we move to CDI to the central index. This interface will go away, and all the activations from Primo Central will be part of your Alma single activation workflow. So what does it mean? It means that during the CDI enablement, when we move you from Primo Central to CDI, we took all the active collections in your Primo Central institutional profile and we moved them to Alma. So Alma now not only allows you to do activations that you are used to for full text and for your link resolver, Alma also allows you now to do activations for search. And that's what I'll be talking about now. The first topic of today is to talk about what happens in the CDI enablement in this process, what is actually included in the report that is generated as part of this enablement, and what do you need to do after the CDI enablement. So when we look at single activation in Alma, I need to first just do a brief recap of the things I talked about in the last session. First of all, you now have two types of activations in Alma. You had an existing type of activation, which you were used to, which is meant for full text and which you were used to doing via the activation wizards. If you used collection zone collections and you activated them, made them part of your institution. So that's the existing activation. But we're also introducing a new type of activation. And this is what we call the CDI search activation or the activation for search. So this is something to keep in mind, just a brief recap. Another thing I wanted to talk about here very briefly is different types of full text writes in Primo Central and CDI. It's the same in Primo Central and CDI. There were actually two types of full text writes that are for collections in Primo Central and CDI. One is that the activation of or the indication that you have a subscription, that you have access to the full text, goes via the link resolver. So this is a subscription link resolver, typically as an indication in Primo Central, in the Primo Central institutional profile. It means that you indicate in Alma via portfolio activation what items in the collection you have a subscription to or you have access to in your institution. So that's the activation via the link resolver. Another thing we have to indicate full text writes, and we had this in Primo Central, we'll have this in CDI as well, is activation on collection level that's not handled via the link resolver. You actually, in for Primo Central, what you did was you when you activated the collection for search, you also activated that it was available in full text at the same time. So the activation was not handled by Alma, not handled by the link resolver. Instead, the activation is on collection level, and it means when you activated it in Primo Central, all the content of the collection was marked as full text available. This was a typical scenario. Here was a collection where the linking was via the link in the provider record, and the activation was on subscription on collection level. So, so these are two types of full text writes in Primo Central. They'll be the same in CDI, but there is an impact on when we actually move from Primo Central to Alma, and I'll talk about that in a minute. So what are the basics for this CDI enablement for moving your Primo Central collections to Alma? First of all, we will look at all the Primo Central collections that you've activated in your institutional profile for Primo Central. We'll take those and we will activate them for search. It's a new type of activation in ALMA. So they all get an indication that they're now active for searching CDI. That's the first thing we will do as part of the CDI enablement. The second thing we do is we focus specifically on Primo Central collections where the full text settings were controlled on collection level. The linking was via the link in the record, the subscription was on collection level. For these, the full text rights are not handled by the link resolver. They were handled by Primo Central. So we need to first of all check if those collections are actually active for full text in ALMA. And if they are not active in ALMA, then we set a special status, and I'll come back to this special status later in the session. It's a status that's called active for full text in CDI only. We do this because we really want to make sure your end users are not losing any full text information when they move to CDI. So if there is no activation in ALMA and the activation was handled in Primo Central previously, we have to make sure that in ALMA these collections get a status that says for CDI, there is full text availability. So that's this special status. And these are the two steps that are essentially taken when we do the CDI enablement for your electronic collections. Now, when we do this moving of activations, we have something which is very important, which is a mapping. And this is a mapping between the collections that exist in Primo Central, and the mapping is against the ALMA community zone. This is what allows us to make sure that two separate, really separate systems, the Primo Central system and the list of collections and the ALMA CZ, that they're mapped, that they are connected to each other, that we know, okay, this collection in Primo Central corresponds to this collection in ALMA. I need to activate this specific collection for search in ALMA. Now, in most cases, we aim for a one-to-one match. One collection in Primo Central represents one collection in the ALMA community zone. However, because of the differences in knowledge bases and collections and the way providers offer packages for linking versus for search, there's not always a one-to-one match. Now, a lot of information about this mapping and why we decided to choose specific packages can be found in the link here that I listed here below. It's documentation that's part of the CDI documentation on the content corner, and it describes what are cases where there is a many-to-one mapping, for example, and where there is no one-to-one match, and also describes if there's multiple candidates in the ALMA CZ, which ones we prefer for our mapping. So this is quite useful information. This mapping is really very important in our CDI enablement process. Okay, so this talked a little bit about what is actually going on. Let's now look at what you will see after the CDI enablement in what we call the Primo Central to ALMA activation report. This report is really a description of everything that happened in your ALMA institution as part of the CDI enablement, and you can find it if you go into the ALMA interface. If you go to resources and then go to advanced tools, you will see a link here which says PC to CDI activation reports. So in this activation report, you will get a list. First of all, you'll see a list in a table that is shown in your ALMA UI. You can also use the export feature to extract this list and get it in an Excel format. So that's also useful. I show that in a screenshot in one of the next slides. So what does this report include? Let's look at it in more detail. The first thing you will see here is you will see for all the Primo Central collections, you'll see the ID and the ALMA electronic collection name that corresponds to this particular Primo Central collection. You also see the ALMA collection ID, and then you see what happens in ALMA for this specific electronic collection. The first column you see here is the CDI search activation. So what happened is for all the active Primo Central collections that are reported in the report, you'll see the value activated. It was activated for search in ALMA because it was active in Primo Central. The next columns are about the full text changes that were made. And I'll come back to that in the next slide. Let's look at some examples of the statuses for the next columns. But first of all, this is a little screenshot of the Excel version of your Primo Central to Alma activation report. Useful if you want to do sorting or filtering on specific types of statuses, or you want to manipulate the list. So you can get this from the Alma export option. All right, so let's look at what's happening. First of all, what we do in terms of CDI search activation. As I mentioned earlier, all the collections that you had active in Primo Central are activated for search in Alma. And what you see there is, so for each of these Primo Central collections, you'll get the status activated in the column CDI search activation status. And for this, we use a mapping between Primo Central and Alma. Now, there's two cases that can happen. First of all, if we find that there is an Alma collection that was mapped to the Primo Central collection you had active, and it's active already in your institution zone, it's available in your institution zone, it's active for full text, we just add the search activate, the CDI search activation to the same record. Now, if we find that the Alma collection that we mapped the Primo Central collection to is not active, what we do is we add this CZ collection to your institution zone and we activate it for search. So those are the two cases that can happen. And I'm showing you here a screenshot of both. So example one is an example where this particular collection was activated for full text by the institution prior to the CDI enablement. And what we, so it was active. You can see that here, it's a community zone record that was activated and is now part of your institution zone. It was active, it has active portfolios, it has a full text service that's active. And what we did is we activated it for search. You can see that because it says active for search in CDI. Yes, this is example one. Let's look at example two. In example two, what happened is a customer created a local database for ProQuest as part of their Alma Alma institution. So this is part of their institution zone. This is a local collection. This is not the collection that we mapped the collection to that existed in Primo Central. Instead, we have another one. This was not did not exist in the institution zone prior to the CDI enablement. So it was added to the institution zone. It's not active in Alma because you see it's grayed out here. So there is a suppressed BIB record here. That's the indication for a database if it's in the institution, but it's not active. And we activated this new collection that we added to the institution zone for search in CDI. So in this case, you have two records in Alma, one that's active for full text, or that you have order purchase order information connected to, or other reasons for having it in Alma. And the second is the one that we think is the authoritative record, or the one that we mapped the Primo Central collection to, and that you can activate for search. And because you had it active in Primo Central, we activated it for search for you in CDI. All right, so these are the two different examples. Now, this is what we do for search activation. Now let's look at what we do for full text activation. And first of all, there is full text settings that are controlled by the link resolver. So this is where, even in Primo Central, the subscription is via the activations of portfolios in the link resolver. So the full text is actually already handled by Alma in Primo Central. It will be handled by Alma in CDI. So you don't need to make any change here. We don't need to make any change during the CDI enablement. So we don't check for full text activations in Alma because the activations were already handled by Alma in Primo Central. So what do you see in the CDI report, the PC to CDI activation report. The first example is an example from Wiley. Again, so the collection is Wiley Online Libraries Open Access. We activated it for search and we are not making any change to the full text activation status for CDI. We don't need to make a change because the activations, the full text indication is based on Alma portfolio activations. And in this case, just for your information's sake, we also added a note. This collection was actually already active in Alma. So that's no changes is done here. This is a link resolver type of collection, so we don't need to make any changes for full text. Now the second example is also an example where it's a link resolver type of collection. Again, we activated it for search. We're not making any full text availability changes. The full text is based on Alma portfolio activations that you had prior to the CDI enablement. In this case, the collection was not active in Alma. Again, this is this node is for your information. You don't need to worry about this. This means that there's probably another collection that has portfolios active that are going to be used for full text availability calculation in Primo Central and in CDI as well. Crossref is an ANI database. This is a typical example. You don't actually need to activate this collection in Alma because there's other portfolios from other collections that handle the full text link. All right, so this is an example of where the full text activation, where the settings are controlled by the link resolver. No changes to full text. Now, let's look at the second scenario where the full text settings are controlled on collection level and the linking is via the link in the records. Here, we do have to do something during the CDI enablement. We have to check whether there is corresponding activation in Alma for full text for this collection. If we aren't going to do that, then we're going to lose full text activations in CDI because these activations were previously handled by Primo Central. So what do we do? If we find that the collection is not active in Alma and we need it for CDI because it's a subscription level collection, we are going to add a special status which says active for full text in CDI only. So this is what you see in the screenshot. The Gale, in this case, a Gale collection was activated for search, and because it's a link in record collection and the collection was not active in Alma, it was activated for CDI only. And that's the status you see here. And let's look at what this looks like in the Alma UI for a particular record. So this particular collection is collection that where the subscription is on collection level and it's a link in records. We found that it was not actually active in Alma, so we activated it for search and we also set the special status full text active in CDI only, yes. This is because otherwise your users would lose full text indications for this collection when moving from Primo Central to Alma. All right, so this concludes the report. Now let's look at what you actually need to do after the CDI enablement. Once you've get the email that your Alma environment is now enabled for CDI, let's have a look at some best practices. So once you get this the information that Alma has been enabled, what is the minimal, first of all, that you need to do? Let's look at this. So the first thing you need to do, or we recommend to do, is to do a quick check of the PC to Alma activation reports. So what you can do is you can take a few collections and you look for them, you take them from the Alma PC to Alma activation report and you look for them in Alma. First of all, you should see for all of the collections in your report the message or the label that they are now active for search in CDI. So it should say yes. And for the ones that in the report say they were activated for CDI only, you should also see the status full text active in CDI only. This means, if you see this, this means the report corresponds to what you see in Alma and the CDI enablement was done well. Second thing you need to do, and that's again still the minimal, is to go to Primo and run a few searches. You just go to your Primo environment, you do a search in either a blended scope or a scope that includes only Primo Central, both are okay, and you look at the search results. Then you add the parameter and search CDI equals true at the end of your Primo URL and you rerun your search. It's best to do this in a separate tab so you can compare them side by side. What this will give you is you're actually going to get search results from CDI instead of Primo Central if you add this parameter. And now by comparing the results, you can check that the results that are returned for CDI are correct in your institution. You can compare them to the ones from Primo Central. Do that both for the filtered search and for the expand search. And keep in mind that the results that you'll see, including the number of results, is not identical. CDI is a much bigger index, and we also use different searching and ranking compared to Primo Central. It's different technology, different index. So don't expect exactly the same results, but you should get results back from CDI that correctly reflect your full text subscriptions, in that you get the correct full text available indications. You should get good results in terms of they should match your search. And if they're known item searches, then they should also appear on the top of your Primo Central result list as well as your CDI result list. Okay, so this is the minimal. Let's look at what you, if you want to do more. Now, there's a few things that we've gotten questions about. So if you want to do more, these are the two things that you may look into. First of all, in some cases, you may want to do some cleanup after the CDI enablement. As I mentioned before, in some cases, if we couldn't find the collection that we as Exlibris mapped the Primo Central collection from, in some cases, you'll have more than one collection active, one for search and one for full text, and you may want to have them more aligned. So that's one reason to do cleanup, and I'll go back, I'll go into some scenarios after this slide. Secondly, you also may want to check alternative coverage collections that you've activated in Primo Central, because the activation is no longer needed in CDI. Keep in mind, everything that you have in full text is automatically searchable in CDI. That's not the case for Primo Central. So alternative coverage is not really needed anymore. So again, not needed for CDI to work properly, but you may want to do some cleanup here. There's two articles that explain what I'm going to go into in the next slides. They can both be found in the CDI content corner section, which contains all the information about CDI. So there are links to both of those documents, and I have a screenshot of one of them. So this talks about preparing ALMA/NSFX and for single activation and checking your activations after the CDI enablement. So this is one of the two documents listed in my slides. So now let's look into some more details and look at some more best practices after the CDI enablement. The first thing I want to talk about is this special status called active for full text in CDI only. As I mentioned before, it's added to some collections during the CDI enablement. If it was a linking record type of collection that was active in Primo Central, and we cannot find any activation for it in ALMA during the CDI enablement, because you had another collection active, or it was the one that you had active is not the one that we mapped the Primo Central collection to. This can also happen because in Primo Central, you really handled the collections in Primo Central. The linking didn't go via ALMA, so there was not always a need to have these collections in the ALMA CZ. So quite a few actually were added to the ALMA community zone because of the single activation project. It simply didn't even exist in ALMA. So you may have created local collections if you wanted to do order or purchase information connected to these. So that may be a reason why you have this status. Now, the question is, do I need to change or remove this CDI only full text activation? First of all, this is not needed. CDI will work just like Primo Central, and your users will get the right full text indications, even if you don't make any change to this status. The only what you could call disadvantages of the status is that the collection is not fully activated in ALMA. And also there may be a local duplicate collection in ALMA that is fully activated. So you then have two. Because the collection is not fully activated in ALMA, it means that the BIP record is suppressed if it's a database type of collection, and the service and the portfolios are not activated for collections with portfolios. Again, we make sure for CDI that your users will be able to get the full text indications when they do a search and find the records. But in ALMA, or maybe in the URESolver, you want to start using those collections. So if you want to make a change, if you want to get rid of this status and make it into change it into real full ALMA activation, what do you need to do? You need to do two things. First of all, you will need to use the action in ALMA to remove the CDI only full text activation. I'll show that in the next slide. That's the first step. And the second is you need to activate the collection using the regular ALMA workflows, which means if it's a database, you will need to unsuppress the BIB record that will make it available for discovery and is an indication in ALMA for database types of collection that this really is an active collection. And for collections with portfolios, aggregator selective packages, you need to activate the full text service and the portfolios. So let's have a look. So this is how to remove the status. So this is an example of a collection that has this indication active for full text in CDI only. So if I want to remove this status, the first thing I do is I go to the actions menu and I choose the action which only exists if the status exists, and you choose remove CDI only full text activation. Keep in mind, if you only do this and then you don't actually activate it, that your end users will lose full text indication for this particular collection. So this is only step one. Let's look at step two. Step two is the actual activation in ALMA, and it's slightly different for database types of collections than for aggregator and selective types of collections. First, let's look at the databases. Databases are in ALMA activated by making sure that the BIB record is not suppressed from discovery. So that can be done either if you start from scratch and you activate a database from the community zone via the activation wizard that's done automatically. But in all other cases, what you need to do is you need to go to the MD editor, go to tools, management tags, and then change it so that you no longer suppress this database record from discovery. So this is for databases. For selective and aggregator collections, the activation is done by using the electronic collection editor. You can access that by clicking here on the edit collection, or clicking on the hyperlink, or using the ellipse here and choosing edit from edit collection from the list. And then you can go to the services and activate the full text service, and then activate the portfolios. So this is the second step if you want to no longer have the status full text in CDI only. Let's look at some other best practices. So I kind of go through a number of examples here for cases where you have more than one collection active and you want to do something about it. Why would you want to do something about it? You may find that even though it's absolutely functional and there's no problem with having two collections active, if you think that's messy or you don't like that and you want to do cleanup, this is what your options are. So the first scenario here is that you have two active collections. One is an active one is a collection that you have active for full text. You may have created it locally, it may have not existed in the ALMA community zone, and so you have a local database which is called ProQuest Congressional, and that existed prior to the CDI enablement. Now during the CDI enablement, we from the community zone found that this particular collection was the one that we had mapped to your Primo Central active collection. So we added that to your institution zone. It's not active for full text, it's grayed out, but it is active for a search in CDI, and that's why it was added. We also added the special status full text active for full text in CDI only, because it's a database type of collection with a subscription on collection level. So now you have two separate collections. If you want to make them into one, have only one record, what are your options? First of all, leave as is. That's the easiest thing to do. No harm in having two collections, one for search and one for full text. CDI will work in the same way it worked in Primo Central. No changes needed. If you want to make a change, you can activate the in CDI yes collection instead of the active ALMA collection. So that means you remove the special status full text in CDI only, and you unsuppress the BIB records. And then it will become an active collection, and you can remove the local collection instead, and only have the one that is the one that has both search activation and full text activation. Now, one thing to keep in mind is that it should not be done. We should, in case there is a currently active ALMA collection that has administrative information associated with it, like orders and licenses. And you can see here that the local collection has an order. So don't just delete this collection because you lose the order information. In this case, we don't recommend to delete the local records, just simply delete it. So this is the first scenario. Important to you can use the CDIS collection. That's nice, but keep in mind that there is a reason maybe why the local one was created, and don't just delete it if it has a purchase order or something connected to it. Second scenario is a different type of collection, and that's a link resolver type of collection. The first example was a database. In this case, what happened was that you had a local collection which was called Royal Society Publications, 11 active portfolios. You activated it for search. Now, this collection cannot be activated for search separately in CDI. And instead, what we did was we added a second collection to your ALMA institution zone where the search activation was added. So now, after CDI enablement, you have two collections in ALMA, one active for search, one active for full text. If you don't like it, let's look at the options. First of all, you can always leave as is. No changes really are needed in ALMA. But if you want to do cleanup, you can activate the in CDI yes collection instead of the active ALMA collection. Again, don't do this if you have a purchase order or some other administrative information connected to it. Just don't just delete it. If there isn't anything connected to it, you can remove it and activate the 11 portfolios in the collection that does have the CDI search activation and is separately, you can separately activate for search. Let's look at a third example. This one is an example where all the portfolios in a specific collection are active. Let's say that, again, this one is called JSTOR Health and General Sciences. You have a collection from the CZ that you activated, and you activated all 63 collections. As part of the CDI move, this was not the collection that was used for mapping. Instead, another one was used for mapping. This is a little bit of a fake example because I couldn't immediately find a real one. So it has the same name. It should never really have the same name in ALMA, but let's assume that this is the case. So what happens is that you now have two collections, one active for full text, one active for search. Both are actually indexed in CDI, so search activation is available for both. Let's see what the options are here. There's actually quite a lot of options. Again, you can leave as is, no need to make any changes. But the first thing you can do is you can activate for search the existing collection that you have active in full text, and then remove this one from your, that was active, was added as part of the CDI enablement. And so this one can be removed if you activate this one for search, and you can, because it's it has in CDI, yes. So that's one thing you can do. Keep in mind that you should only do this if really they are the same, if they have the same amount of portfolios, the one that you have and the one that is it was activated for search. Quite a few cases, there are subsets or less complete packages that may be included in ALMA that are not complete. So in that case, you could lose some search activations if you activate the one that was not used in the mapping. Another thing you can do is you can say, well, there's no purchase order, there's no real reason why I should be using this one. Let's say you find that actually it is a smaller set of portfolios than the one that we activated for search. What you can also do is you can activate the portfolios in the one that's active for search, activate the service, activate the 63 portfolios, and then remove the one that you were using before. Again, be careful here that you should not do that if you have administrative information connected to the collection before. Now there's one more option, and that is available because all the portfolios are actually active for this collection. If that is the case, then let's say you have this this whole package, you don't subscribe selectively, but all you subscribe to all the portfolios, you don't actually even need search activation anymore. Because keep in mind, this is something I told last session, and I want to repeat here, everything that you have in full text is automatically available for search. So all the portfolios going to your CDI holdings file are picked up by CDI. So they all appear in your filtered search. They all appear in your expand search. You don't have inactive portfolios for this collection. So really, you don't even need the search activation here. This is search activation is for the expand search. So that's a fourth option here. Only available, of course, if all the portfolios are active. So these are the four options available to you for this specific scenario. This is an exceptional case in the sense that you don't always have these four options. This is just because all your portfolios are active here, and because both your the collection that you had in full text prior to the CDI enablement and the one that was chosen for the mapping both are in CDIS, so they can be activated for search, and they're very identical. They have the same amount of portfolios. I just want to list here all the options that you have, and I hope this gives you a better understanding of what search activation is and what the options are for doing the duplication. Okay, so let's look at two last best practices, two last examples, and they're both about open access collections and what to do after the CDI enablement. First one is a collection I picked, which is a database type of collection, which was active in Primo Central. It's called SweepUp, and it was activated for search in CDI because you had it active in Primo Central, and because it's a database and it has its the subscription is on collection level, it's actually open access, which is the same, and it's the link is via the link in the record. We set the status full text active in CDI only to yes. Now, what do you need to do after the CDI enablement? Do you need to do anything? First of all, you can leave it as is. You can also remove the full text active in CDI only yes and change the activation to be real activation. In the collection. This is a database, so it means you unsuppress the BIB. Your gray icon will become a blue icon. You'll no longer have this special status, and it will be a real active collection in your ALMA institution. Now, if you do that, there's actually no real difference in the user experience here, because your user will see full text available for all the records in the collection. They'll be able to search for all of them. It's just if you want to do some cleanup, if you don't like the gray icon, you can do that. You don't like the status, you want to have consistency, you could consider doing it. But there's no user difference in the user experience here. So you can also leave as is. A second example of an open access collection is an open access collection that is not of the type database, so it has portfolios. And here what we did is we saw that this collection was active in Primo Central, so we activated it for search in CDI. We don't make any, we didn't make set the special status for full text in CDI only because it's a link resolver type of collection, so the full text indication is actually via the link resolver. But again, it's not fully activated. It's you see, it's gray. What can you do when you get this type of collection in ALMA? First of all, again, you can leave as is. The collection is searchable, just like in Primo Central, and the linking is the same as in Primo Central. It will use activation from other collections that you have active in ALMA. Now, what you can do is you can activate this collection. You can activate the service by using the electronic collection editor. You can activate the portfolios. In this case, there is a difference in the user experience. You will get more active portfolios in ALMA. So they will see more, for more records, they potentially will see full text available in their discovery than they had before. So this is because it's a link resolver collection. It's selective. It has portfolios. So if you activate the portfolios, your users will see more full text. Okay. So these are the best practices that I wanted to talk about after the CDI enablement. The next part of the session, the last part of the session, is some general best practices. Not related to the enablement, but just going forward about single activation in ALMA in general. First of all, I just want to have a brief recap of what we talked about in the first part of the session earlier this month. What kind of activations do you need for searching CDI? Which electronic collections do you want to activate now that you're using CDI? Keep in mind, very important, that search activation is not needed for alternative coverage and has an impact only on your expand search. That means only records will be added after you do search activation only for those records where you don't have full text. So CDI search activation is useful for content that is not available in full text in your library, but your users should be able to discover it. And the reason for this is that everything that you have in Alma, that you have active in Alma for full text, automatically becomes searchable. Very different from Primo Central, where you had to do search activation. Otherwise, you wouldn't even get to records that you have at full text for. CDI, this is not the case. Everything you have in full text is automatically available, goes out in the CDI holdings file and will get the full text available indication. The search activation is important for the expand search where you don't have the full text. So how do you activate collections for search? There's three ways in which you can do that. The first one, and that's I think is the easiest one, is as part of the activation wizard flow when you activate a new collection from the community zone. If you click on the activation wizard for a CZ collection, the first step of the activation wizard will, in case the collection can be activated for search separately, will have a section which is called Central Discovery Index Information. And this is where you set the CDI search activation. Now, by default, we already set this search activation status to active. You can, of course, change that and go to the next step in the wizard. But this is the first way in which you can activate collections for search in CDI. And it's done automatically if you don't make any change. The second thing is, once you have a collection in your institution zone, you can use, or even community zone for a collection that's not active, you can use the action to activate for search in your electronic collection result list. I don't have a screenshot of that. I'll come back to it and show it in a minute. The third way in which you can do it is by using the CDI tab, this CDI tab in the electronic collection editor. The first field that is configurable here is the CDI search activation, can be active, not active, and you can change it there. So these are the three ways in which you can activate collections for search in CDI. So next thing I want to talk about is the option to not show a particular the records from a particular collection as full text available, even if you have it active in Alma. I'm going to talk about it and some best practices for this, because it's come up in quite a few questions we got from customers. I want to go into more details here. We also call it the suppress from CDI option, and the place you can find this option is in the electronic collection editor. If you edit a collection and you go to the CDI tab, then you see this field, do not show as full text available in CDI, even if active in Alma. This option by default is not turned on. Let's look at what is the impact of this option. If you use this option, you override a general rule. And the general rule is that all full text collections that are active in Alma will be automatically searchable in CDI, and they'll be shown as full text available in both the filtered and the expand search. If you want to override this general rule, then you need to use this option. So when do you use the option? You use it if you want to use to have full text activation in Alma for the link resolver, but you don't want to have it as shown as full text available in the discovery, because it could clutter the result for your users. You don't want to have duplicate ebook results. I'll come back to that in a minute. Or you don't want book chapters in the results. So these are some examples why you would want to use the option, or when you want to use the option to not show something in discovery, even though you have it active in Alma. So when you use the options, when you use the option for a collection, then records associated with the collection will not appear in the filtered search, and they'll also won't show up in the expand search. There is an exception. You can have them show up in the expand search if you activate them for search. It's a separate activation option. They will appear in this case, but they will not get the full text online indication. Now, if you use this option for a specific collection, you have to keep in mind that what this does is it takes all of the portfolios for a specific collection out of the CDI holdings file that is published to CDI as part of your publishing profile. But if the same book or the same journal is also available from another collection that is active for full text and it's not suppressed, it will still appear as available, full text available in CDI. So it only works if you suppress it completely, not just from one package, but also from, if available, also from other packages. The collection also will still appear in your link resolver. So this has an impact only on CDI. It doesn't have an impact on any other collections that you, not via the discovery, that users can link to. So if they use PubMed links or Google Scholar link, or they link from somewhere else, they'll still see the full text showing up in from your U-Resolver. One other limitation is that the option is currently available only for electronic collections that have the in CDI yes indication, but we'll be changing that in the ALMA July release. Let's look at handling duplicate ebooks, because this is also something that came up in the listserv and there's quite a few questions around it. What happens is that ebook records appear in CDI in two cases. One, in case the collection has portfolios that you had active for full text in ALMA. And what happens in that case is the portfolios are published to CDI. And in addition, you also publish the bib records from the local Primo index. So thus, you get duplicates, you get records from CDI, and you get records from Primo, and these are not deduplicated. They exist, so they'll both show up in the in your result list in the discovery. It was the same in Primo Central, but the solution was different in Primo Central. I'll come back to that. We don't merge duplicates found between the local and CDI. So this is why you see duplicates. You also see duplicates in case an ebook collection is active for search in CDI, but then it will be only in the expand search. So this is something that that is less noticeable, and that is because of activations for search in case you don't have a full text subscription. I'll focus on the first scenario. So how was this handled in Primo Central? In Primo Central, you could deactivate a book collection, and that will make sure that it doesn't appear in your search results. Now in CDI, since all active full text portfolios are automatically published to CDI, you will get duplicates, and you cannot deactivate for search because your full text is actually what will cause the records to appear in your filtered search with full text availability. So in CDI, if you want to prevent duplicates, we recommend that you either use one of the two options that are available. The first is to use the suppress from CDI option that I talked about earlier to check the do not show as full text available. Oops, sorry, in CDI in the CDI tab of the electronic collection editor. That's one option. Or you can also, so then you will take care of removing the ebooks from CDI. Or alternatively, you can also suppress the bib records from being published to your local Primo index. So in this case, you're suppressing the you've suppressed the local records. If you suppress them from CDI, the impact will be that it will prevent not just the books from being no longer included in the CDI searches. It also will prevent any book chapters that we index in CDI from appearing. So this is something that you need to keep in mind. If this is something you want, then this is the option to go for. If you use option two, which is to suppress the bib records from being published, then your users see the records from CDI, not from your local Primo. And it will make sure that, or the impact is that you will still see book chapters because we index the ebooks in CDI, but we may also index the chapters, and you will also see those, and they'll also be marked as full text available as well. So if that's what you want, then this is the option to go for. So both options have pros and cons, and you need to check what applies best in your institution. Now, one thing to keep in mind is if you see duplicates and they're not duplicates from between the local records and CDI records, but they're actually two CDI records, then this is an issue with our match and merge process. And this can still occur if we find that our match and merge process doesn't identify duplicate records in CDI and they're still appearing. So in that case, you cannot use the two options. You have to then report them to via a Salesforce case, and content our content team will need to look at that and see how that can be fixed in CDI. So that's a separate issue. It doesn't have to do with duplication between local and CDI records. There are a few changes in ALMA to improve the ebook handling. First of all, we are going to allow you to use the suppress from CDI option for all collections, regardless of whether they're marked as in CDI. This will be part of the July ALMA update. That's the first thing. Second is that we will add a search filter to ALMA to allow you to filter by collections that have this setting in your ALMA institution. And that is going to be part of the advanced search, and that will be part of the August ALMA release. So that's coming. Okay, this leads me to the last slide, and that is, where can you find information about CDI, and where can you find help? First of all, there's a lot of documentation, including lots of the topics that I talked about today, also including best practices in the FAQs, that you can find in the content corner of the the Ex Libris Knowledge Center in the central discovery section. So there's a lot of information there. There's also information about single activation in the ALMA online help. If you have specific questions that are really specific to your environment, or problems that you find in your environment, we encourage you to create a support case so we can track the issue and we can get back to you when, after analysis and with information about when it's going to be fixed. Secondly, if you have more general questions, we encourage you to contact us at the email address cdi_info@exlibrisgroup.com. This is not for specific problems that you have, but more in general questions. So don't hesitate to contact us. So